This story will cover from then to now and next, all about change, how to turn losers into winners. There is a fish in the oceans that has been sought for and studied more and more as its value and rarity has increased. But that icon of the ocean, the bluefin tuna, the Porsche of the sea, has now almost reached the end of the line. That is being allowed to happen in the full knowledge of those implicated in its potential extinction. We will identify them and ask why on earth they are doing this. They have a lot to answer for, and the situation may be solvable. If not, they will be responsible for the last nail in the coffin, the final chapter in the history of a magnificent creature at the hands of man. He's hunted them on the high seas for ages. The Sicilian tonara is the oldest existing forerunner of the modern pound nets, specially invented in prehistoric times for the capture of tuna and other migratory fish in the Mediterranean. Those were the good old days, though not so good for the tuna, and setting the huge nets in a traditional shape was a skillful and dangerous job, particularly in rough seas. In Spain, the Almadraba trapped the migratory bluefin tuna as they passed.
And here fishermen share the beach with sad signs of the times. The extensive ruins of Bailo Claudia date back to the 2nd century BC. The town was founded on tuna and mackerel, which was made into a sauce called garum. Because of the putrid stench of the stuff, the vats were placed by the sea as far away from the town as possible. The migrations of the tuna brought riches to many parts of the Atlantic coast of southern Spain. Whole communities dependent on the passing of these great fish. So many came and kept on coming that the people must have thought it would continue forever. But today, they know that's not the case. Off Barbate, they still await the great fish which remain the symbol of the town. The harbour still stores great anchors for great nets. But this is a dying tradition. There are not plenty more fish in the sea. These kinds of empty scenes are now common along most of the fishing coastlines of the world.
Jacques Cousteau saw the changes for himself.
Amid a school of damselfish, the divers enter a watery universe filled with constellations of life. Here, the tuna-like lychia. There, a ray drifts along the bottom. Everywhere, in endless variation, the sea teems with hunters and hunted. In 1977, Cousteau and the Calypso divers returned to Veyron. In only 3 decades, the sea floor has become a desert, bleak as the surface of some barren planet. 10 years, no fish. In 10 years, the marine life will be finished.
Thank you. In the United States, there had been a great mystery as to where the famous bluefin tuna breeds, and it was south of Florida that the detectives turned out to be bird biologists and not fish biologists.
After fishing out at sea, the parent sooty tern somehow has to find its own chick on the island. When biologists collected the food that had been passed to the chick, they found bits of bluefin tuna fry. But an individual bluefin that survives to reach full size will have increased its weight 1 billion times. So the riddle was solved. The starting point of the bluefin's epic journey was discovered, and now it's a question of following them. Around Cape Cod, there are big schools of tuna, but they're not easy to spot.
Can't see anything yet.
Tripp's skills will bring in the boats which are already assembling in the area. He looks for clues, like where the big whales are feeding, watched by the whale watchers. The tuna may be after the same food as the whales. Or, in the shiny distance, a slick from shoals of fish, or even from their oily bodies, as they're attacked by the tuna squadrons. He's spotted a school. It could be worth $1 million. And he brings the harpooners in.
Yeah, I can see them. They're just below me now.
They launch the harpoon from the greatly extended bowsprit. And there's the school, right by a whale. Trip Wheeler also helps find and photograph bluefin tuna for research. With such a valuable resource at stake, it's essential to try and estimate numbers. But how many schools are there? And how many are deep and out of sight? There are many questions to be answered about these elusive migrants that can move so far and so fast. At present, almost every single major fishery around the world is being overfished, and that includes tuna and their prey. The big bluefins have now arrived off Canada, following the herring and mackerel, and they're all heading for trouble. For the mackerel fishermen, this could be a big bonanza. Not only do they get the bluefin's prey, but they get the big prize as well, the Porsche of the sea. Inevitably, they get others, like the strange sunfish, which lives on plankton. They get in to check the catch. That could be worth as much as a Porsche. And the sunfish? Nothing. There's a huge wastage of so-called trash fish, though some may be used to feed the Porsche. Bluefin is built for speed. They use up huge amounts of energy in swimming and must eat an enormous quantity of food, up to a quarter of their own weight every day.
When they've been fattened up, they're flown to Japan. They're dead and they're going by air. Below them, others may swim across the Atlantic, but they too may end up dead in Japan. Such is the apparently insatiable appetite for sushi, sashimi, and such. With Japan's Princess Takamado comes some good news from Mitsubishi, helping the Wildfowl and Wetlands Trust save an endangered duck, the Madagascan pochard, the rarest duck in the world. But can this be the same Japanese corporation that is apparently investing in the extinction of an endangered fish, the bluefin tuna, another species that's very special? If a global species is the property of the planet, then it's hardly surprising when a lot of people protest. Around the world, headlines. The Japanese do not need to eat bluefin tuna, but if they are fished to extinction in the Mediterranean to supply Japan, then those fishermen's jobs will be extinct too. Even cats may suffer from overfishing. Cod collapsed in Canada despite all the warnings. Now the fight is on to save the bluefin, and it's Japan, not Canada, that is in the headlines. And the film End of the Line that focused the spotlight on Mitsubishi. More news. In June 2010, Sea Shepherd's helicopters and divers raided cages being towed by Libyan and Italian fishermen and released 700 to 800 bluefin tuna. There was a fight. Apparently the cages were overstocked. Many were illegal juveniles, and they were caught after the official closure of the season and exceeded the quotas.
Bluefin scientists are recommending a catch of 15,000 tons simply to avoid collapse. In order to rebuild the fish population, the catch needs to be less, at 10,000 tons. But ministers vote for a catch of 29,500 tons, twice what it should be to keep the population from crashing, and three times what it should be to let the fish recover.
I just can't accept that. This is a political quota. It's negotiating with biology, and you just can't do that and expect to see the biology survive.
This is a species which is as endangered as the white rhinoceros, and yet it's being hunted to extinction in the Mediterranean. It's being exploited at more than twice the level it should be, and those countries that have overfished it are not being forced to pay back what they've overfished, so not a day in which the European Union has covered itself in glory.
Turtles left the building. A little less conversation, a little more action, please. One fish can be worth $100,000. A large female can lay millions of eggs. There should be a future for all in there somewhere. But unless the restaurants, and especially the customers, reject this overconsumption, as the current global reports make clear, everyone, from the big boys to the poor deprived fishermen, will lose out. As the politicians of Spain, France and Italy are now being exposed in the bluefin business, the media will look more and more closely at deals between Europe and Asia. This is truly a global product. The Gulf of Mexico, hit by the BP oil spill, is one spawning area. Another is south of the island of Majorca in the Mediterranean. The plan is to protect that area so that bluefin tuna can multiply exceedingly, as they do. And in the meantime, pressure may be taken off existing stocks and illegal fishing stopped. Maybe. It's very difficult to police effectively. Meanwhile, the end is in sight. Now the world is looking at a news item at the end of 2010 in Time International about the protected zones. And in National Geographic Worldwide, the challenge now.